Hello and welcome to Disc Review, the podcast that goes track by track through a different album each week.
And we're your hosts, Max and Matt. Join us as we explore some of our favorite records.
No, I'm a fan, I swear.
I feel like I've become a music normie.
I'm tired of being Mr. Positive Guy.
Dude, that's not human.
This is certifiably the most boring album I've ever heard.
And there's a reason they don't do it, because it's terrible.
We hope you enjoy the show. Let's get into it.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Disc Review, the podcast where typically we go through track by track of a different album each week. But today we wanted to just try something different. We hope you guys like it. We thought we would do kind of like a top 10 list, top 10 favorite albums for us. And as we were creating that, we found that it's pretty hard to make a top 10 favorite album list. What did you think about making this, Matt?
Well, first of all, this is we're reviewing multiple discs today, right? This is
discs.
This
review.
Is a top 10 favorites, but right, it's just like sometimes you like forget about an album you liked before, or you haven't heard an album in a while, and maybe you wouldn't like it as much now, but you had good memories, right? You used to like it, or you had a good time with it, so. It's really going to be an imperfect list, and I kind of just went through a lot of music I'd listened to, a lot of my like songs on Spotify, and just kind of was like, well, what kind of albums do I feel like I went back to a lot and resonated a lot with me, but not necessarily like this is like my most objective list of every music, you know, like it's not going to be a perfect list. It's just some things, some albums I felt like highlighting. Some of them we reviewed and some of them we haven't, and maybe we will eventually, but it was definitely a tough list, right? Because you're not always going to remember everything about every album. And I'm not going to, you know, listen to all these albums again right now. A lot of them I do know really well and know everything about. But yeah, it's tough to be that objective about music sometimes.
Yeah, and I want to make clear that what this is not is like a top 10 best albums of all time list. Because that's just, you can't pinpoint that down. It's like everyone's list is going to be different. I can't say what the best albums of all time are, but I can say what my favorites are generally. So that's kind of what this is going to be. Also, I think it's okay if these lists end up changing eventually. Like I had a list on my phone of my top 10 favorite albums. And when I was preparing for this episode, I went through that list and I realized that a lot of them needed to change. So I changed them and updated them to how I feel.
I'll tell
now.
You what, there's a lot of albums where it's like I loved this album at a time, like a lot of like Perseverance stuff, right? Because we have a lot of history listening to that band, but it's like I'm as opposed, I didn't put them on my list, and it's just like because I've changed, I'm older now, it's different. Maybe the music hasn't held up for me as much as well, but it's like I do have a ton of great memories with that stuff, so it was really hard to make a list for that reason too, because I'm like, well, I'm coming at it from my perspective now, but there's tons of stuff that I've liked and still has, you know, a place, but, you know, I've maybe just moved on from, right?
Yeah, you know what? Pierce Seville didn't make my list either, but if we had made this a few years ago, they probably would have.
Right?
So it's...
Exactly. It's just a tough... Maybe we'll do another one. We'll update it every once in a while. I think just something fun to talk about a bunch of records we really like, and I don't know, just kind of... It's fun.
It is a lot of fun, and I had a lot of fun making this list. So how about we go from starting... I have my list from... 10 to 1, as in like 10 is my least favorite on the list and it works its way up to my favorite on the list. Is that kind of how you did yours?
I couldn't really order it. I don't know if I'll have an exact order. I can kind of like, as each album goes by, kind of talk about how it might rank a little bit, but no, I'm so bad at ranking stuff.
That's okay,
I didn't even really try.
I put mine in a ranking list, but to be honest, like when I look at it, it's like, man, is this really the list I'm going to go with? But we'll go with it. So why don't we start it off? I'll start off with my number 10. Is Hollywood's Bleeding by Post Malone. Hollywood's bleeding, vampires feeding, darkness turns to dust. Everyone's gone, but no one's leaving, nobody left but us. I just really like this album. I don't know, like I'm not even the biggest Post Malone fan. Like he has a lot of stuff that I haven't even really listened to. But I just feel like every song is solid on this record. I have a lot of fun listening to it. I think the lyrics are enjoyable. So it's kind of odd because this isn't really my scene, but I come back to this record very often.
I haven't gone through the whole thing, to be honest. I don't know how we haven't done this record yet, but there's some absolute, right, just huge pop bangers, very popular songs everybody knows. But I haven't gone through the deep cuts, so I don't know much about it. I've heard a couple.
Yeah, we'll go through it eventually, because that's definitely a must. Like, everyone loves Post Malone. He's huge right now, and this is probably his most popular album, I would assume. I don't think his most recent one did all that well.
Yeah, I don't think it did. I didn't hear much, you know, on the radio or anything, but there's some good ones on there. But this one was definitely huge for him, right? Circles was huge, Sunflower was huge.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean I like a lot of what Post Malone does.
So what's your first one you're gonna say?
All right, for my first pick, I'll go with something a little different. I tried not to pick too much of the same artist, right? Like, it's just kind of, I don't want all five 1975 albums to take up the entirety of my list, but we'll start with Gone Now by Bleachers. That's why I'm out in the streets and I was slinging wind out my teeth, cause somebody didn't fix them nice. You know, some things just don't turn out right. This is his second album. I just think it's really unique, great production, great, just great songwriting. I've just kind of noticed that, like, a lot of the albums I picked were all from, like, a similar era. I don't know if, like, the way we listen to music has changed now, or if, like, I'm just old and stuck in my ways and listening to music I used to listen to, but a lot of it's from, like, 2017, kind of 2018 era, and I don't know if, like, you have, like, a similar trend on your list or what.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of what I listen to is definitely from, like, when I was in high school. I try my best to stay up to date on, like, what's relevant in the genres I like to listen to. And I think that music is, like, there's no one good era. Like, there's always going to be good music in any era. You just got to find it. But I think that a lot of people kind of get, they latch on to the stuff they listened to in high school, kind of probably because that's just when you're, like, coming into your own person, right? That's when you form your music opinions, and, like, it's probably very solidified over those few years.
Well, what's your second pick?
Well, yeah, so my second pick, I'm wondering if we're gonna have any overlap here.
I think so. I mean, there's a lot of albums we've already reviewed that we really liked and that we gave great reviews and probably deserve to make this list. I know I have.
All right.
So, well, I think so.
Well, yeah, my number nine is The Great Depression by As It Is.
Well, there's one.
Yeah, I don't know, man. This was the first album that we ever reviewed for this podcast. And I don't even really listen to it that much. I think I think about it a lot because the concepts are so strong. I mean, this album has such great lyrics about anxiety and depression as well as suicide that I think that it sticks with me throughout the years. Even when I'm not listening to it, it's in the back of my mind. So that's why I like The Great Depression.
Well, I actually, it's a little caveat for my pick. I picked the reimagined version of that record. I'm the poet and the problem, the bleeding of the stitch. I'll tell you it's okay to die to stop you giving in. I'm the poet and the problem. Dude, I just really like the concept of just totally revamping a song with, like, the same lyrics, same melodies, but just totally different style. And it just brings so much variety to that reimagined version. Like, which one? The Stigma, Boys Don't Cry. Like, that song is so different. It's got this upbeat saxophone, synth kind of poppy sound, but it's still got those, you know, really dark lyrics. And it's just, like, you wouldn't expect that for that song, but that's just because it is. It's a reimagined version, and it's just so unique, and I like going through it. And some of them are, I think for the most part, a lot of them I like better on the reimagined, too, and I think that's why I chose that version. But, I mean, as a whole, I think, like, you kind of pick and choose from each, and you got a pretty cool record there.
I definitely agree. I wish that more bands would do, like, a reimagined version of stuff. I'm getting so tired of just the acoustic versions. It's so boring. Like, if you're going to write some good acoustic songs, then great. I'm all for that. But just turning your regular songs into acoustic songs it's boring now. So doing a whole revamp is very interesting, keeps it fun, and it allows you to explore different sounds. So, but my number eight is And this is probably going to be a, if there's any metalcore kids listening to this podcast, they're not going to like me for this, but it's Pressure by Wage War. And I was going to pick either Blueprints or Dead Weight by Wage War, because those are the more popular albums, and they're really good, and I like them a lot, but I don't, it's just the songwriting on Pressure is just so good, and the reason I think I'm going to get hate for that is because everyone I've talked to about this record has disliked it, and I don't really know why. I was hanging out with one of my buddies, and we brought up that we both liked Wage War, and we were talking about it, and he's like, oh, what do you think about Pressure? And I was like, man, I have that shit on repeat. I love Pressure. It's awesome. And he's like, oh, man, you didn't get the memo? Pressure is bad.
I hate when you feel like you didn't know, yeah. Like the rest of the community knew something you didn't. You're like, hold on.
Yeah.
We don't like this. This isn't
good. Oh, I'm not supposed to like that? Okay. I follow a lot of like online communities for music, and in every one that I've heard them talk about Pressure, they always say things like the production isn't as good and like it's not as heavy as their other albums, but I don't think those things matter when the songwriting is just superior. I think that they wrote some great choruses, super catchy, every song is huge sounding, so I just really like that album a lot.
Yeah, that's what matters. I agree. For my next pick, let's see. I think I'll talk about Mama's Boy by Lainey. Yeah, I mean,
oof, great.
I don't
pick.
Know if that's on your list too, but great I pick. We loved that record and we reviewed it, and I still like it. Is one of the newer albums on my list, and I just have such great memories. I still put that on all the time when I want something chill to listen to, because it is kind of that sound. It's a lot more laid back, but still a ton of emotion there and some great songwriting. I just it holds a special place in my heart. I just love this album.
And herein lies the problem with making lists like this, is because if I had remembered that album, I probably would have thrown it on my list too, because it's so good, but I forgot about it.
Yeah, it happens.
All right, my next pick, and I imagine that you'll have this one too, but I'm not going to say for sure, but it's Beautiful Mess by Say We Can Fly. Somewhere I'm watching over you, somewhere I'm not letting go of you, and I will always sing you back to...
Yeah, I mean, we gotta shout out our boy.
Our boy, yeah. We did a little interview with Say We Can Fly. You can check that out on our channel. And so that was really awesome that we were able to do that. He's a huge influence for me and my songwriting. And his voice is just so good, man. Everything he sings is just beautiful. He's great at capturing emotions and writing about breakups, especially, I think, is his forte. And so the Beautiful Mess album, I think, with very, very few problems that it has, I think, other than those problems, it's pretty much perfect. It's a great album.
Yeah, I mean, he's just, the production is so good. I've really been, like, just so impressed at how good he is at producing music and making it sound so good, so unique, right on top of his great voice that I just can't get enough of. My next pick, I'll start talking about the 1975. I picked A Brief Inquiry. I think when we reviewed a lot of the early 1975 albums, I didn't put this as a top, but it probably is my personal favorite of theirs. There's so many great standout songs on there, and just really came out at a time where I really just got lost in that album, and I've spent so much time listening to that record, so just absolutely had to make the list.
Yeah, that was probably my favorite one out of the ones that we've reviewed. I really enjoyed listening to that one. And I liked the themes that were like, that stick with you and are present in almost all the songs. That was a great one. I'm really excited to review their newest one because I think that also might be one of my favorites out of all their records.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll have to get around to that.
All right, number six for me. And this one, it technically, I don't even know if this technically counts as an album, but I'm going to do it anyways because I like it so much. I put Inside by Bo Burnham.
Get up. Get up. I'm talking to you. Get the fuck up. Get your fucking wheel up. Get on out of your seat. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. Hey, fuck it. Get your fucking hands up.
Wow, that's a good pick.
It is a good pick. It's for those of you who don't know, Bo Burnham is a comedian, and this is a record full of comedic songs, and they go to this kind of movie that he made that's just brilliant, I think. It has a lot of great things to say. It's very interesting. It's very funny, and it even has some songs on there that aren't funny. They're just beautiful. And so I think it's super cool. I was so mad when I tried to show my wife Inside by Bo Burnham, and she thought it was dumb. Like, she did not like it.
Really?
And I was like, no, my heart. So I like it a lot.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good pick, and I'll tell you why, because I also picked it. That is an absolute, I don't know, just masterpiece of work of art, both that and the film that goes with it. I constantly have these songs come on shuffle, and I'm listening to them as songs. They're good songs, great writing, great lyrics. He is so clever, and it's just what, and he just sells it, and he just completely commits to this and just absolutely nails on a lot of songs. And right, and some of them are serious, some of them aren't even really there to make that much of a joke. It's just more of like commentary sometimes, but I don't know. I still think what he had to say was funny and insightful, and on top of that, just great catchy songs. That's good music at the end of the day. So absolute. I was excited to, I think we'll probably do a whole episode on it, but I kind of suspect you might put it on here too, because I know we're big fans of this album.
Yeah. I think that this is the best work of art to come out of the pandemic, because I'm sure you remember when the pandemic started, everyone started writing these COVID EPs. This my
made from my bedroom in a pandemic.
My quarantine self-produced album.
Thoughts on quarantine,
and it was just so overplayed and so dumb. But this just felt so unique and interesting.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I guess you also put that there. So is it my turn again?
Yeah.
All right. Number five. We're halfway through. This one, you won't know this one, I don't think. It's called The Death of Me by Polaris. They're a metalcore band.
Mm-mm.
And I chose this one. I had to throw some heavy music on here. Because it's a very heavy album, but also I just think that it's so fun. Like, I have the most fun listening to this album, and it has some really cool lyrics, some really insightful lyrics, I think, in some places. And in other places, it's not as insightful. It's mainly just to be cool, to have fun. And I think that's important too in music. So that's why I picked that one.
For my next pick, I'll go with Divide by Ed Sheeran. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell. I really like Ed Sheeran. I mean, he's the number one artist in the world, so it's not really a hot take, but I wanted to, you know, throw on one of his records, and I think this is the one I'd pick as my favorite of his work. I just, I don't know, I've just some great songwriting. I kind of just him at his prime for me. He still makes good stuff, but I just, this album particularly just stuck with me. I liked a lot of their, a lot of the songs on here.
Yeah, you wouldn't know the artist I like. He's kind of underground. No, I agree. I love that album. It's awesome. I remember when it came out and I didn't like it because I was really stuck in my I only listen to heavy music phase, and everyone was jamming it and I was like, I don't get it. And now years later, I get it. It's a great album. All right. My number four, and it is criminal that we have not reviewed this album. I think I've brought it up a few times and it just got lost in the mix because we had to do other things, but Nicotine by Trevor Daniel. My last made me feel like I would never try again, but when I saw you, I felt something I never felt. Come closer, I'll give you all my love. If you treat me right, baby, I'll give you everything. My last made me is literally, it's my number four on here for a reason, because it's one of the best albums I've ever heard in my life. I love every song. His voice is awesome. It's not even that his voice is like super flowery and pretty. It's just cool. And the songs are so much fun. I listen to this one so much that my wife makes fun of me every time we're on a road trip because I always throw it on. And she's like, we literally listened to this last week. But I listen to it all the time still, even though I've listened to it for years.
Yeah, we haven't done that one. But yeah, let's do it soon. All right, my next pick... Obviously, I'm not in any particular order, but just kind of throwing things out. Reputation by Taylor Swift. I don't like your little games. Don't like your tilted stage. The role you made me play. The fool. No, I don't like you. I have listened to a ton of Taylor Swift. She really is that good of a songwriter and artist. Some of these artists, I try to like, I go for the artists and then picked my favorite album from them.
Yeah.
Right. This is probably my favorite of hers. I don't know. I just think it's so unique. That production sound, it was just kind of came out of nowhere, but is really strong. And there's just so many great tracks on there. And she made an album recently that kind of had the same style, kind of felt like a successor to that album. But Reputation stands supreme for me. I think it's just such a good album.
Yeah, I've never been the biggest Taylor Swift fan, but I thought her Folklore album was really cool. It was very different from her usual style, and it was, a lot of fun to listen to. But I haven't given Reputation that much of a chance, so I'll have to. We'll review it, I'm sure, and we'll talk more about it in depth.
Yeah, I think we should.
All right, my number three pick is "Dispose" by The Plot and You. The Plot and You is one of my very favorite bands. I love them so much. And I was gonna pick their newest album, which is called Swan Song. But I don't know. Because I love Swan Song, and I was gonna pick it because I thought the production was just really great and there was some cool themes throughout the album. But I throw this one on more. I come back to it more. I remember it more because it was just very influential for me. It's got songs like, you've probably heard of it, but didn't know what it was. Feel Nothing. Have you heard that?
Okay.
It's like it's popular on TikTok. But that song goes super hard. And there's two other songs on that album that just crush it. Like some of the best songwriting I've ever heard.
Yeah. I've heard of them, but I've never listened to them. So we should dive in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I just played it. This is definitely a TikTok song. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's funny. That's a funny kind of music to go mainstream like
it's,
that.
It's hilarious way, right? Anytime something like this goes mainstream, because it's like, I've been listening to this since I was 17. You can't listen to this now, but it's okay. It's cool.
Also, throw on another 1975 album. I like it when you sleep. Just such an iconic album for me, and so many memories of falling in love with this band in particular. Just alone for the nostalgia for me will always carry it. But on top of it, it has probably my favorite 1975 song, "The Sound." So, yeah, I just think the production on this was so unique, and is what got me into them.
That's funny that your favorite song on there is The Sound, because on the album I just said, Dispose, there's also a song called The Sound, but it's the worst one. but, no, yeah, I like that one as well. I'm trying to think of a 1975 album that I didn't really like that much. I'm thinking maybe the Notes on a Confessional Form. That probably wasn't my favorite, but both.
Yeah, I talked about it on that album or that episode, but if you just cut away some of the songs that aren't right, good, I think yeah. there actually is might be their best record in there.
Yeah, I agree.
It just kind of gets lost in there.
All right, my number two, and I'm just switching my number one and my number two right now because I decided that number two is better. So,
last minute change.
Yeah, last minute change. But number two is going to be Verses by Omarosa. When we reviewed their other album, I said that, what is that album called that we reviewed? So this is some live research I'm doing right now. Peach Club. And I didn't forget that because I didn't know it. I forgot it because my brain is slow. Peach Club we reviewed, and I think I said on that review that that was my favorite Omarosa album. But I made a switch here, and I'm going with Verses because I just have so many good memories listening to Verses. And every time I throw it on, I am brought back to those memories, and it's a really good experience. It's probably the best type of experience you can have with music, is to be transported to a memory of your life that just felt great, you know? And so I just think that this album does that for me, and every song is great. Even though the songwriting probably wasn't as good as they are now, they're more personal to me.
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't that much into this record, but I've heard it. I really like I'll Just Wait off that. That's the one I did get into.
Yeah.
But definitely more of like into that Peach Club era. But yeah, I know what you mean. Like a lot of these albums I picked for that, right? It just transports you to a different time. And then that's kind of what I was talking about with I Like It When You Sleep. It just reminds me of a different time and getting into an artist, right?
Yeah.
I also threw on my list GGBBXX from Lainey. It kind of is like a package deal with me with Mama's Boy. These albums came out so close together, but
yeah, a year apart.
Lainey has quickly become one of my absolute favorite artists, and this one and that other one are just, they're so good, and I'm always throwing on tracks from these two albums, and I just could not throw them on here.
Yeah, man, I wish I had remembered Lainey when I was making my list, because either one of those albums could have made mine.
Yeah.
They're both that good. And have we talked about both of them?
I think so.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, go listen to those reviews. If you don't know Lainey, go check them out, because they're sick. They're really awesome. All right. I'll restate. My list is in order from least favorite to favorite. So my number one favorite album of all time is Ever Blossom by This Wild Life. And
okay.
If you know me well, this is probably a shock of an album to be my number one, because I listen to a lot of heavy music, but this album is just so soft and so pretty and so beautiful. And it's like, I'll put it on all the time, and I will still almost be brought to tears by some of the lyrics. There are multiple songs on there that just feel so, like the feeling of them is just so strong. And it's like, I don't even personally relate to what they're talking about, but I still feel it, because it's just such great songwriting, such yeah. great lyrics. And his voice, man, it's just so, he sings like all the songs in falsetto, like almost the whole way. And it's something I haven't really heard other artists do, but I like it a lot.
Yeah, I haven't even heard of them.
They're not big.
I didn't even know what music they made, yeah.
Yeah, they're not big at all.
So many of my picks have kind of hopped on with yours because we had so much overlap. I think I got through all of mine, but I wouldn't even know how to rank these.
Oh, you did all yours as well?
I think.
Alrighty. Well, yeah, I did 10 for sure. I got them all listed right here. So honorable mentions, I'm going to say Happier Than Ever by Billie Eilish. I think that's a great album as well. Just didn't quite make the cut for me. Any other albums you want to just throw out there, just name drop?
I thought about throwing on some Maroon 5, but man, their highs are so high, but their lows on their deep cuts are so low. Yeah. It holds them back from it, right? Like, that was the one thing that was going through my mind trying to find some artist. But no, not really.
Yeah, and you know, even on some of these records that I mentioned, there's like songs within there that I don't like.
Yeah.
Like, but the highs are high enough to carry it. Well, I had a lot of fun doing this, dude.
Yeah.
Thank you for listening to this episode of Disc Review. We'll come at you next week with another episode. And hopefully we'll get to
drop your top tens.
Yeah,
drop your top tens in the comments. And feel free to hate on ours. That's fine.
Oh, yeah. Well, I wouldn't even care if you said that our lists were trash. Because we love them. And that's what's important. All right. Thank you, guys. We'll see you later.